Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alicia Mess Classes. So today I'm going to start exercise 7.9 of chapter number 7, integrals. But before that, those who want to see the solutions of previous exercise, that is exercise 7.7, they can just click in the I link. The description is given over there. We are not doing exercise 7.8 because this time CBSE has cut that exercise for the session 2020-21. So we are not going to solve that exercise 7.8. And right now I'm going to start exercise 7.9 exercise, and this exercise is based upon definite integrals. So before proceeding to the solutions of exercise 7.9, let me introduce what is the meaning of definite integral. So any integral of the form this integration limit a to b fx dx, this type of integration is called definite integral. Why do we call it definite integral? Because as we know that whenever we will integrate this function with respect to x, we get fx, some other function fx, and the constant of integration c. Due to the presence of c in this integration, we call this integration as indefinite integral. But how we will solve this definite integral? Let us check. Now how to put the limits? First of all, we have to put the upper limit. That means in place of x, we have to put the value of x is equal to b, and then minus lower limit. Lower limit, that means in place of x, we'll put x is equal to a. So what do we get? Let us see here. So in place of x, if I'll put b, I get f of b plus c minus f of a plus c. Now in the next step, you know that when I will open this, I will I can cancel c by this c because this constant can be cancelled. So finally I'll get f of b minus f of a. So you can see here that there is no constant of integration in the final answer. That's why we call this integration as definite integral, because these are definite and the c has been cancelled. Because of the presence of c in the definite integral, in the indefinite integral, we call that indefinite. So here in definite integral, we are not having any constant of integration. So this is the only logic for the indefinite integral. So let us start exercise 7.9 and we will just see how to solve the questions of this type. So students, let's see question number 1. First of all, you can just see here that integration of these type of functions you have done already in exercise 7.1, 7.2. So this exercise is just based upon the definite integral. That means limits are given and we have to just put the limit by the formula upper limit minus lower limit. So let us see, already you know how to do the integration of x. So in the integration of x is x square upon 2, and the integration of 1 with respect to x is going to be x. So now first of all we have to put the upper limit. That means in place of x we'll put x is equal to 1. So I'm going to get 1 square is equal to 1. 1 by 2 plus the value of x in will be 1. So this is upper limit minus. Now in place of x we have to put lower limit. That means in place of x I'm going to put x is equal to minus 1. So minus 1 whole square is going to be 1. And minus 1 into x is going to be minus 1. Sorry, in place of x, if I'll put x is equal to minus 1, so plus minus will become minus 1. So finally, when I'll solve it, minus minus will become plus. So minus half will be cancelled by half and the answer will be 2. So the answer is a constant in this case, because in this case, we are going to put the values of upper limit and lower limit. Now see the next question. The integration of 1 by x, everybody know that the integration of 1 by x is log x. So this is very simple question. Now we are going to put the upper limit, so we get log 3. In place of x we have to put 3, and in place of lower limit we have put x is equal to 2. So now applying the formula of log m minus log n is equal to log m by n. So this is our final answer, log 3 by 2. Moving on to the next question. First of all, we have to do the integration of this function. Now 4 is a constant, so we can take it outside. The integration of x cube is going to be x raised to power 3 plus 1 upon 3 plus 1. So that means x raised to power 4 by 4. Similarly, 5x raised to power. 2 is there, so how to do the integration? X raised to power 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1, that means x raised to power 3 by 3. Plus 6, x raised to power 1 is there, so that means x raised to power 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus 1, that means x square by 2. And finally, 9 is a constant, so you can take it outside. In the bracket will just remaining with 1, that is integration of 1 with respect to x is going to be x. Now upper limit is 2 and lower limit is 1. So cancelling the 4 by 4, I'll get x raised to power 4 minus 5x cube by 3. This 2 can be cancelled by 6, so I'll get 3x square plus 9x. Now we have to just put in place of x, we have to put the upper limit, that means x is equal to 2. So I'll get 2 raised to power 4 minus 5, 2 cube upon 3 plus 3 into 2 square plus 9 into 2. So here we have just put the upper limit minus, now I'm going to put the lower limit. So in place of x, I'm going to put 1. So I get 1 minus 5 by 3 plus 3 plus 9. So solving this, I get 2 raised to power 4 is 16, 2 cube is 8, 8 5 the 40 by 3, plus 2 square is 4, 4 3 the 12, plus 9 to the 18, minus, so when I will open this, all the signs will get changed, so minus, or we can just simply solve, 9 plus 3 is 12, so 12 plus 1 is 13, so I'll get minus 13, plus 5 by 3. So solving it, we get, now we know that 16 plus 12 is 28, and 28 plus 18 is going to be 46. 46 minus 13 is going to be 33. So I left over with 33, and minus 40 by 3 plus 5 by 3 is going to be minus 40 plus 5, means minus 35, minus 35 by 3. Taking the LCM, I'll get 3 as a LCM. So 3 into 33 becomes 99 minus 35. So answer is 64 by 3. So this is the answer. Please note down. So student, next is question number 4. That is integration limit 0 to pi by 4 sine 2x dx. So first of all, we'll know that the integration of sine x is minus cos x. So therefore, the integration of sine 2x is going to be minus cos 2x. And again, the coefficient of x is 2. So we have to take in the denominator also. Now we have to just put the limit. So you can do one thing. You can take minus 1 by 2 as a constant outside. See, this is a constant. We can take it outside. Now only thing left is that we have to put upper limit. So I get 2 into x, that means 2 into pi by 4, minus lower limit, that means cos 2 into, in place of x, I have to put 0. So I get answer, cos 2 will be cancelled, so I get pi by 2 minus cos 0. Now cos, the value of cos pi by 2, that is cos 90 is 0, and cos 0 is 1. So when I will multiply, I will get 1 by 2 answer. Moving on to the next, that is fifth question. So same integration of cos x is sine x. So I get integration sine, integration of cos 2x will be sine 2x. And the coefficient of x is 2. So we have to take in the denominator. Now 1 by 2 is a constant, so we can take it better outside. Now in place of x, I have to put upper limit, that is pi by 2. And in place of, again, then we have to put the lower limit in place of x, we have to put 0, so 2 into 0 becomes 0. So half into 2 will be cancelled by 2, I get sine pi minus sine 0. Now the value of sine pi is 0 and the value of sine 0 is also 0. So answer will be 0. The next question is integration limit 4 to 5 e raised to power x dx. Now the integration of e raised to power x is going to be e raised to power x. This is very simple question. Now we have to just put the upper limit, that means in place of x we have to put 5, in place of x we have to put 4 as a lower limit. So answer will be e raised to power 4, we can take common, and this is the answer. Please note down. So students, next moving on to question number 7, that is integration limit 0 to pi by 4 10x dx. So first of all, we must know what is the formula of the integration of 10x. So we have already done in exercise 7.1, 7.2. The integration of 10x is minus log cos x, or you can write down log secant x. You can write down both. You can use any one of the following. So I am using minus log cos x, integration limit 0 to pi by 4. So now I am going to put upper limit, that is pi by 4 minus lower limit, that means 0. So minus log cos pi by 4. Cos pi by 4 is log 45 degree. The value of log 45 degree is 1 by root 2. And minus minus will become plus. The value of cos 0 is 1. Now, this is actually of the form log m by n. So, can be written as log m minus log n plus log 1. Now, the value of log 1 is 0. The value of log 1 is 0. So, it becomes 0. Minus minus become plus. So it will be log root 2, and this also becomes 0. Finally, it can be further modified in by this way. So square root can be written as 2 raised to power 1 by 2. Now we know that log m raised to power n can be written as n log m. So that means whatever is there in the power, it will come in the starting in the multiplication, and log will be implied applied on the function m. So in the same way, the answer will be 1 by 2. It will come in the multiplication and answer will be 1 by 2 log 2. Now next is integration limit pi by 6 to pi by 4 cosecant x dx. So we know that the integration of cosecant x is log cosecant x. Log cosecant x minus cot x. Integration limit pi by 6 to pi by 4. Now, firstly, we have to put the upper limit, that means in place of x, we'll put pi by 4. So I'll get cosecant pi by 4 minus cot pi by 4. And in place of x, now we have to put the lower limit, that means log cosecant pi by 6 minus cot pi by 6. So now, cosecant pi by 4 is actually cosecant 45 degree, and the value of cosecant 45 is root 2. The value of cot 45 is 1 minus log. This is actually cosecant pi by 6 and this is cosecant 30 degree. The value of sine 30 degree is 1 by 2. So the value of cosecant 30 degree will be reciprocal, that is 2. And the value of cot 30 degree is the reciprocal of tan 30 degree. The value of tan 30 degree is root 3. So it will be, the value of tan 30 degree is 1 by root 3. So the value of cot 30 degree will be root 3. So this is now of the form log m minus log n. So can be written as log m by n. So now further you can, I think this is the answer. So you can just note down, this is the answer of the form log m minus log n. Moving on to the next 9th question, that is integration limit 0 to 1 dx upon square root of 1 minus x square. So first of all, we must remember what is the formula of integration of 1 upon square root of 1 minus x square. So the integration of this is sine inverse x. Because we know that the derivative of sine inverse x is 1 upon root 1 minus x square. So the integration of this will be sine inverse x. So now we have to put upper limit, that means sine inverse 1 minus sine inverse 0. The value of sine inverse 1 will be pi by 2. And the value of sine inverse 0 is 0. So answer is pi by 2. So students, next is 10th question, integration limit 0 to 1 dx upon 1 plus x square. So we have to remember what is the formula of integration of 1 upon 1 plus x square. It is actually tan inverse x, because the derivative of tan inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square. So integration is going to be tan inverse x, limit 0 to 1. Now putting the upper limit, I will get tan inverse 1, and putting the lower limit, I will get tan inverse 0. Now the value of tan inverse 1 is going to be pi by 4, and this is 0. So answer will be pi by 4. Very simple. So moving on to the next question, that is integration limit 2 to 3 dx upon x square minus 1. So I told you this is actually exercise 7.4, integration of some particular function. So it can be written as x square minus 1 square. So this is the integration of the form dx upon x square minus a square. And the formula is 1 upon 2 into a log x minus a upon x plus a. This is the formula we have done in exercise 7.4, integration of some particular function. If you have not watched my video of that particular functions, you can just see in the description box, the given link is given over there of exercise 7.4. We have given the introduction of some particular functions and the derivations also. So you can just check from there. So 1 by 2 is a constant, better you can take it outside. Now, in place of x, we have to put upper limit. So I'll get 3 minus 1 upon 3 plus 1 minus lower limit, that means 2 minus 1 upon 2 plus 1. So it becomes log 3 minus 1 becomes 2, 2 by 4, which can be cancelled by 2. So I get 1 by 2 minus log, it becomes 1 by 3. So it becomes a formula. Log m minus log n can be written as log m by n. So m is 1 by 2, n is 1 by 3. In the next step, 3 will be shifted over in the numerator and 2 will be shifted in the denominator. So final answer is 1 by 2 log 3 by 2. So this is the answer. Moving on to the next, that is question number 12. Integration limit 0 to pi by 2 cos square x dx. So students, I told you this is the question of exercise 7.3, in which we have done the integrations of trigonometric functions, basically those who are in the power of trigonometric functions. And I told you whenever we are having sin square x, cos square x, then we have to apply trigonometric identity that we have done in class 11th. So the formula of cos square x, first of all, we have to put the formula of cos square x, and it is, you have done in 11th class, cos 2x is equal to 2 cos square x minus 1. So using this formula, I'll get 1 plus cos 2x upon 2. This is the formula of cos square x that we have derived from here. So students, you have done in 11th class. So 1 by 2 is a constant. You can take it outside. 1 by 2 is a constant. Integration of 1 with respect to x becomes x. And the integration of cos 2x will be sin 2x. And the coefficient of x is 2 here, so it will come in the denominator. Integration limit 0 to pi by 2. So now what we have to do, first of all, we have to put the upper limit. So I'll get pi by 2 plus sin 2 into pi by 2 upon 2 minus lower limit. If I'll put lower limit, I'll get 0 and sin 0. So both become 0. So actually lower limit becomes 0. Don't need to write down. So now it becomes pi by 2 plus sin 2 will be cancelled by 2. So it becomes sin pi upon 2. So now the value of sin pi is 0. So 0 upon 2 becomes 0. So finally the answer is pi by 4, because this becomes 0. So answer is pi by 4. Please note down. Next question is question number 13. That is integration limit 2 to 3 x dx upon x square plus 1. So students, here we will use substitution method, because you can see that we are having x square plus 1 in the denominator and we are having the derivative of the denominator in the numerator. So let's see how to do this question. So first of all, we can just put x square plus 1 equals to t. So x square plus 1 is equal to t. So that means differentiating both sides, we get 2x dx is equal to dt, or x dx is equal to 1 by 2 dt. So it becomes 1 by 2 integration limit 2 to 3. So putting the value of x dx is equal to half of dt. Half we have taken outside dt and xk plus 1 we have taken t. So now the integration of 1 by t with respect to t is going to be log t. But students, the limit of this 2 to 3 is for x and the function is in the form of t. So we have to replace the value of t. The value of t is log of x square plus 1 limits 2 to 3. So first of all, we have to put the lower limit, upper limit. Upper limit is 3. So 3 square is going to be 9. 9 plus 1 is 10. And lower limit is going to be 2. 2 square is 4 plus 1 is going to be 5. Now log m minus log n becomes log m by n. So it becomes 1 by 2 log 10 by 5. And answer is 1 by 2 log 2. So this is the required answer. Students, next is question number 14. That is integration limit 0 to 1, 2x plus 3 upon 5x square plus 1 dx. So students, first of all, we have to split this integral into two parts. So it becomes 2x upon 5x square plus 1 dx plus 3 is a constant, so we can take it outside. Integration limit 0 to 1, 1 upon 5x square plus 1 dx. So in this integral, students, with what we can do, we can take 2 common outside. So it becomes x dx upon 5x square plus 1. And in this integral, this is actually of the form x square plus a square. But for that, we have to take 5 common. So 5 can be taken outside common. So it becomes x square plus 1 by 5. So students, in next step, what we are going to do, we will just put 5x square plus 1 because this is actually the function and this is the derivative. So we can take 5x square plus 1 equals to t. Differentiating both sides, we get 10x dx is equal to dt or x dx is equal to 1 by 10 dt. So this integral becomes 2 is already there and 1 by 10 can be taken outside. So it becomes integration limit 0 to 1 dt by t plus 3 by 5 integration limit 0 to 1 1 upon x square plus 1 by 5 can be written as 1 by root 5 whole square because we have to apply the formula of 1 upon x square plus a square, which is 1 upon a tan inverse x upon a. So in the next step, 2 can be cancelled by 10. So we get 1 by 5 log. The integration of 1 by t is going to be log t. Integration limit 0 to 1 plus 3 by 5 into the integration of 1 upon x square plus a square is going to be 1 by a tan inverse x by a. Integration limit 0 to 1. Now students, you can just mark a line. In the next step, we know that this integration limit 0 to 1 is on the function x and we are having function t. So first of all, we have to replace the value of t, that is 5x square plus 1. So we will replace here, the value of t is 5x square plus 1 integration limit 0 to 1 plus this root 5 can be cancelled by 5. So we get 3 by root 5 tan inverse. This root 5 can be shifted into to the numerator, so it becomes root 5x from limit 0 to 1. So now we just put the limits in both the functions. So when I will put the upper limit, that is 1. So I will get 1 square is 5 plus 1, 6. Minus, if I will put the lower limit, so I will get 5 into 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is going to be log 1. Plus 3 by root 5. Tan inverse. If I will put x is equal to 1, so I will get 10 inverse root 5. And if I will put 0, so I get 10 inverse 0. So students, we know that the value of log 1 is 0. So answer is 1 by 5 log 6 plus 3 by root 5 tan inverse root 5. Because the value of tan inverse 0 is 0. So this is our final answer. Please note down. Next question is integration limit 0 to 1 x into e raised to power x square dx. Although it looks like that we have to apply the formula islet or integration by part, but students, one thing you can just observe here that we are having x square and the derivative of x square is of the form 2x dx. So better to use a substitution method because that will be very convenient. So let us put x square is equal to t. That means 2x dx is equal to dt. And here we get x dx is equal to half of dt. So putting the value of x dx is equal to half of dt. And this x square is t, so it becomes e raised to power t dt. And the integration of e raised to power t with respect to t becomes e raised to power t only. But now this integration limit 0 to 1 is on the limit x. So we have to replace the value of t here. So the value of t is x square. Now we just need to put the limits. So putting the upper limit, so I get e raised to power 1 square is 1. So e raised to power 1 is e and e raised to power 0. So something raised to power 0 is 1. So answer is half of e minus 1. Please note down. Next is question number 16, that is integration limit 1 to 2 5x square upon x square plus 4x plus 3. So student, this is actually the function of the form where the degree of numerator and denominator are same. So we have to apply the long division method. So 5 can be taken outside. And if I will divide x square plus 4x plus 3 by x square, I will get 1 as a quotient and 4x minus of 4x plus 3 as a remainder. So this I will get this. Now 5 into the integration of 1 with respect to x become x. Integration limit 1 to 2 minus 5 integration limit 1 to 2 4x plus 3 upon x square plus 4x plus 3 dx. So if I will put the upper limit 2 and lower limit 1, so 2 minus 1 becomes 1, so I will get 5 minus 5, and let us consider this integral as I1, mark this equation as 1, where I1 is equal to this integral, 1 to 2, 4x plus 3 upon x square plus 4x plus 3 dx. So students, now we will separately solve this integral and then we will put the value in equation 1. So this is the function in which we are having a linear equation in the numerator and a quadratic equation in the denominator. So we have done the formula that whenever we are having the function in this form, so linear function is equal to a times derivative of denominator, that is d by dx of x square plus 4x plus 3 plus b. So it becomes 4x plus 3 is equal to a into the derivative of this becomes 2x plus 4 plus b. So it becomes 2ax plus 4a plus b. Now if I will compare the coefficients, I will get 2a is equal to 4. Comparing the coefficients of x, this implies a is equal to 2. And if I will compare 4a plus b is equal to constant 3, so putting the value of a is equal to 2, 4 into 2 is 8. So 3 minus 8 becomes 5. So b is equal to minus 5. Using this value, this I1 becomes, see this is 4x plus 3 and it can be written as a, that is 2 into 2x plus 4 minus 5 upon x square plus 4x plus 3 dx. So students, 2 can be taken outside. See, 2 can be taken outside. It can be written as 1 upon 1 to 2, 2x plus 4 upon x square plus 4x plus 3 dx minus 5 integration limit 1 to 2, 1 upon x square plus 4x plus 3 dx. Now this is actually the function in which we are having a function in the denominator and its derivative in the denominator. So we will put x square plus 4x plus 3 is equal to t, and the derivative of this is dt. So dt by t becomes log t. So answer is this: 2 log t, in place of t I am having x square plus 4x plus 3, x square plus 4x plus 3, integration limit 1 to 2 minus 5, integration limit 1 to 2 dx upon, this is actually the quadratic equation which can be integrated by using complete square formula. So we will add and subtract 1. So in the next step, this complete will become. So students, by putting the upper limit, 2 square is 4, 4 plus 8 is 12 plus 3 is 15 minus log, putting the lower limit, that is 1, 1 plus 4 is 5, 5 plus 3 is 8 minus 5, integration limit 1 to 2 dx upon, this can be written as x plus 2 whole square minus 1 whole square. So now students, it become, see, log 15 can be written as 3 into 5. Similarly, log 8 can be written as 4 into 2. Applying the formula of log mn, that is log m plus log n, so can be written as log 3 plus log 5. Similarly, log 4 minus log 2 minus 5. The integration of 1 upon x square minus a square becomes 1 by 2a, a is 1, log x minus a. So x plus 2 minus 1 becomes x plus 1 upon x plus a. So x plus 2 plus 1 becomes x plus 3, integration limit 1 to 2. So in the next step students, let's see what does it becomes. So 2 log 3 plus 2 log 5 minus 2 log 4 minus 2 log 2 minus 5 by 2. So it becomes, when I will put the upper limit, so it becomes log 2 plus 1 is 3 and 2 plus 3 is 5. So it becomes log 3 by 5 minus log, putting the lower limit, that is 1 plus 2 is 2 and 1 plus 3 is 4. Now this is actually of the form log m by n, which can be written as log m minus log n. So it becomes, we have to write down this term as it is. It can be written as log m by n, can be written as log m minus log n. So log 3 minus log 5 minus log 2, and minus minus will become plus log 4. So students, in the next step we have to take terms all together which are having log 3, log 2, log 4, and then we have to evaluate. So let's see what will happen. 2 log 3 plus 2 log 5 minus 2 log 4 minus 2 log 2 minus 5 by 2 log 3. Minus minus will become plus 5 by 2 log 5. Minus minus becomes 5 by 2 log 2. And minus plus becomes minus 5 by 2 log 4. So now, see how many terms are there of log 3, this one and this one. Taking the LCM 2 to the 4, 4 minus 5 becomes minus 1. So I'll get minus 1 by 2 log 3. Now seeing the log 5 term, 2 plus 5 by 2. So taking the LCM 2 to the 4 plus 5, that is 9 by 2 log 5. Then log 4. Log 4 is this one. So 2 into 2 is 4. 4 minus, minus 4 minus 5 becomes minus 9. That is minus 9 by 2 log 4. And finally the terms containing 2 is this and this. So 2 into 2 is 4, minus 4 plus 5 becomes 1, so that is 1 by 2 log 2. So students, from the first and last term, you can take, see 1 by 2 can be taken outside. So students, this becomes log minus 1 by 2 we can take outside. So it becomes log 3 minus log 2. Similarly, from these two terms, you can take 9 by 2 common. I will get log 5 minus log 4. Now applying the formula of log m minus log n is equal to log m by n. So it becomes 1 by minus 1 by 2 log 3 by 2 plus 9 by 2 log 5 by 4. Though this is the value of actually I1. So now the value of I1 is this. So we have to put the value. So putting this value in equation 1, from equation 1, so answer of I is equal to 5 minus 5 into I1. So 5 into the value of I1 is this one. So put this value, 9 by 2 log 5 by 4 minus half of log 3 by 2. So solving this, 9, 5 into 9 becomes 45 by 2 log 5 by 4. Minus minus will become plus, plus 5 by 2 log 3 by 2. So this is the answer. Please note down. Next is question number 17, that is integration limit 0 to pi by 4, 2 secant square x plus x cube plus 2. So first of all students, we have to split this integral. So 2 can be taken, or you can directly do this. The 2 is a constant, so so you don't need to do anything. The integration of secant square x is 10x. The integration of x cube will become x raised to power 4 by 4, and the integration of 2 will be 2x. Now we just need to put the value. Putting the upper limit, that means 210 pi by 4 plus pi by 4 raised to power 4 by 4 plus 2 into pi by 4. This is the upper limit. Minus, if I'll put the lower limit, I'll get 210 plus 0 raised to power something is 0, and 2 into 0 becomes 0. So lower limit totally vanishes, or it becomes 0. 10 pi by 4 is 1, so it becomes 2. Pi raised to power 4 can be written as pi raised to power 4. 4 raised to power 4 into 4 becomes 4 raised to power 5 plus 2 will be cancelled, so it becomes pi by 2, and this completely becomes 0. So value is 10, 0 is 0. So answer is 2 plus pi raised to power 4. This 4 raised to power 5 can be solved. 4 raised to power cube is 64 and 4 square is 16. So when we will multiply it, we get 1024 plus pi by 2. So students, this is our answer. Please note down, this is our answer. Next is question number 18, that is integration limit 0 to pi sine square x by 2 minus cos square x by 2. So students, one thing we can do here, that we can take negative common, and it becomes cos square x by 2 minus sine square x by 2. In the next step, you will understand why we have taken negative common, because in 11th standard we have done the formula cos square x minus sin square x is equal to cos 2x. This is the formula of cos 2x is equal to cos square x minus sin square x. So we are having cos square x by 2, sin square x by 2. So it becomes the formula of cos x. So this is nothing, just the formula of cos x. So putting the value, this complete is actually cos x. Now the integration of cos x is sin x. So putting the limits, upper limit becomes sin pi and lower limit becomes sin 0. The value of sin pi is 0 and sin 0 is also 0. So answer is 0. Please note down. Next is question number 19. That is integration limit 0 to 2. 6x plus 3 upon x square plus 4. So first of all, we will split this integral into two parts. So 6 can be taken outside. It becomes x upon x square plus 4 dx. And similarly, 3 can be taken outside. It becomes 0 to 2, 1 upon x square plus 4 dx. So in the next step, what we can do, we can take x square plus 4 is equal to t. And for this first integral, so differentiating, we get 2x dx is equal to dt, or x dx is equal to half of dt. So putting the value, half can be taken outside, integration limit 0 to 2, x dx can be used as half dt, half taken we have taken outside. So here we get only dt, and x square plus 4 is t, plus 3 integration limit 0 to 2. This is actually the integral of the form 1 upon x square plus 4 can be written as 2 whole square. So it changes the function of the form particular type 1 upon x square plus a square. 2 can be cancelled by 6, so it becomes 3. The integration of 1 by t with respect to t becomes log t 0 to 2 plus 3. This is the integration of time 1 upon x square plus a square. So its integration is 1 by a tan inverse x by a. So in the next step, we have to replace the value of log t. T is here, x square plus 4. Integration limit 0 to 2 plus 3 by 2 can be taken outside. So putting the upper limit, that is 2, so it becomes 2 by 2. And putting the lower limit, that is 0 by 2, becomes 0. So now students, in the next step, putting the value of upper limit, so we get 3 log 2 square become 4, 4 plus 4 becomes 8, log 8, minus, if I put the lower limit, that is 0, so 0 plus 4 becomes 4, log 4, plus 3 by 2, this 2 will be cancelled by 2, so I get 1, and the value of tan inverse 1 is pi by 4, and the value of tan inverse 0 is 0, so the correct answer is 3 log, this is log m minus log n, can be written as log m by n. So 8 upon 4 becomes 2 plus 3 pi by 8. So this is the answer. Please note down. So student, next is question number 20. That is integration limit 0 to 1. X e raised to power x plus sine pi by 4x. So students, first of all, we will split this integral into two parts. That is x e raised to power x dx plus integration limit 0 to 1 sine pi x by 4 dx. So in the first integral, you can see that this is the function of the form islet, because we are having the product of two functions, that is x and ex. So first of all, we will consider this function as I1 and this as I2. Mark this equation as 1. I1 is equal to integration limit 0 to 1 x e raised to power x dx. So for this type of integral, we have to do integration by parts. This is first function and this is second function. So integrating by parts, what do we get? The formula is first function as it is, integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function, that is x, and integration of second function whole dx. So this is the formula, and the limits are 0 to 1, so we'll put here 0 to 1. So x e raised to power x minus the derivative of x with respect to x is 1, integration of e raised to power x becomes e raised to power x. Again students, taking the integration, I'll get e raised to power x, because 1 into e raised to power x becomes e raised to power x, and the integration of e raised to power x is same. Now we just need to put the value of x is equal to 1 here. So 1 into e raised to power 1 becomes e raised to power 1 becomes e, minus lower limit 0 into something becomes 0, and e raised to power 0. So e will be cancelled by e in this case, and final answer is 0 minus e raised to power 0 is minus 1. So minus minus becomes plus 1. So this is the value of I1. So now we need to find out value of I2, that is 0 to 1 sine pi x upon 4. Now we know that. So students, now the integration of sine theta is minus cos theta. So it will be minus cos pi x by 4. And the coefficient of x is here pi by 4. So it will come in the denominator, integration limit 0 to 1. So now this 4 will come in the numerator. So minus 4 by pi can be taken outside and it becomes cos pi x by 4, integration limit 0 to 1. So now we just need to put the value upper limit minus lower limit. So putting the upper limit, I will get cos pi by 4, and putting the lower limit, I will get cos pi into 0 becomes cos 0. So the value of cos pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. And the value of cos 0 is 1. So multiplying it by this, I get 4 by pi minus 4 by pi root 2. So students, putting this value in equation 1, from equation 1, answer is, the value of I is, the value of first integral is 1 and the value of second integral is 4 by pi minus 4 by pi root 2. So this is the answer. Students, this 4 can be written as 2 into 2. So 1 root 2 will be cancelled by 2 root 2. So it becomes 2 root 2 by pi. So note down. Next question is 21, that is integration limit 1 to root 3 dx upon 1 plus x square. So student, this is actually MCQ question. It is very simple. The integration of 1 upon 1 plus x square is tan inverse x 1 to root 3. So now putting the upper limit, we get tan inverse root 3, and putting the lower limit, we get tan inverse 1. The value of tan inverse root 3 is pi by 3 and the value of tan inverse 1 is pi by 4. So taking the LCM, I will get 4 pi minus 3 pi. So answer is pi by 12. So this is correct, option D. Option D is correct. This is pi by 12. Please note down. Next is question number 22. That is integration limit 0 to 2 by 3 dx upon 4 plus 9x square. So first of all, students, although it is in the that form, a square plus x square, but we have to take 9 common. So taking the 9 common, it becomes 1 by 9 and this becomes 4 by 9, which can be written as 2 by 3 whole square plus x square. So students, now this is in the form of 1 upon x square plus a square, and the integration of this is 1 by a, that is 2 by 3 tan inverse x by a, that is 2 by 3. Integration limit 0 to 2 by 3. So now students, 3 will be cancelled by 9. So 3 into 2 is 6. So it becomes 1 by 6. Tan inverse. Putting the upper limit in place of 2 by 3, we get 2 by 3. And in place of x, now we have to put the lower limit, that is 0. Now 2 by 3 will be cancelled by 2 by 3. So we get 1 by 6 tan inverse 1 minus the value of tan inverse 0 is 0 and the value of tan inverse 1 is pi by 4, because at pi by 4 the value of tan is 1. So answer is pi by 24, which is the correct option is C, pi by 24. So students, today we have discussed the same integration part, although we have done in exercise 7.1, 7.2, but here we learnt some more formulas, how to find out the integration, and this is basically definite integral, in which we have learnt how to put the limits and why this type of integration is called definite integral, because of the absence of the constant of integration, that is C. So I hope so, students, that you like my video and you have understood all the concepts which we have done today in exercise 7.9. So if you like my video, please like, share and subscribe with your friends and family. Thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes. In our next video, I'm going to start next exercise 7.2. So stay tuned with us. Thank you.